Good so far. Hi. All right, we'll just hope it's a Discord thing. People will tell us. I love that Real Chili's in chat. Who's with us then if that's Real Chili? He's like, wait, if we wait. Hi, Chili. I did. So like they want to take what it like Thunder and then Shin, think Warcraft where like or even EQ. EQ. I'm sorry. I'll go EQ. I'm so sorry. All right. fucking RuneScape. Well, guys, let me break it down in the words of Rift. So did I! Yes. Second light, well, you can fly. Are we? Yeah, no, it says I'm streaming. I'm signing in now, so I can adjust. Yeah. Yeah. Ah, that's great. That's beautiful. I love it. I love that Klaus is right now. He's like, great stream. It's just Flatus talking to himself. Nobody's here. Nobody heard that. Nobody. I can make them hear you. Hold on. There, they can hear you now.
Can you hear us now?
Yeah, they can.
Do you want to hear us?
I don't know. I don't know if they do.
Hey, Klaus. I know Shock and Horror. I'm on the show.
I was listening. Oh, go ahead.
Guys, we need to go down to streaming. Let me drag everybody down there.
All right.
Because we can't get in there.
Yay!
You're there now. Oh wait, you guys can't.
I've been suppressed.
You're not suppressed anymore. Go ahead.
Help! Help!
I'm trapped in a box.
God, I felt like I was in Ireland again. Get it suppressed for my religion. Flatus, I'm getting off that topic.
Flatus, I'm not drunk right now. My camera is out of focus, right?
Yeah, you're super out of focus.
No, you're
this is weird.
Did you just like bap it on the head? Like bap.
I was trying to see if I can force it to focus. Hi, stream.
Hi, this is Pre-Show. Welcome to Pre-Show.
Where everything's hell.
Yeah. I wonder if Mubot can give points. I'll start giving out points.
Oh my god, they're doing the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. On the background, when I spend most of my day, shitting out my day. Fuck.
Oh, jeez. What's going on?
When a couple of guys were up to no good started making trouble in your neighborhood.
I'm going to reboot my camera quick.
Shin got into one little fight.
And Gladys got scared? But...
I moved in with Paul's mom in a house in Bel-Air.
As Lava Scorpion went to Bel-Air.
Yeah. Why is Lava Scorpion in Bel-Air?
Because it's for the rich people. Oh. Yeah, let me see his.
What's going on? I got double.
I just got a text from my mom.
Did you?
Yeah, I'm moving.
Do you know what she said?
Oh, she's watching?
She's gonna go fuck up.
I like Klaus's. She said you're moving your auntie and uncle in Lava Scorpion's cave.
Ugh. Oh, I've been there. I don't like it.
Too hot for me. Too hot.
There's also like really buff creatures. I don't. Have you noticed that all the creatures in Lava Scorpion's cave are all jacked?
Because he puts them through a gym membership. They have to be amazingly strong to get there.
That's where
he also likes Bulbasaur's.
Bulbasaur.
You don't miss Abday when you're down in that cave.
If you do miss Abday, you get fucking put in the lava. You will burn for your.
Yeah, I don't have enough sounds on the board, which is probably Shin's probably thankful for. But the reason why I need you guys down here is so you can hear this. Yeah, I should probably.
Ha ha.
Yeah, you can hear that.
Yeah.
What?
I don't even know.
Paul. I mean, we know it's Paul.
Evil Meg Ryan? Yes, Evil Meg
Evil
Ryan.
Meg Ryan. Yeah. Evil Meg Ryan?
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you.
We can hear you now.
Great, my mic decided to stop working for a bit. It's always great right before a show.
Yeah.
Hey, it's before the show, so yeah. That is the great time to do it.
Let that happen now.
I have my popcorn-flavored Tic Tacs ready, because those are a thing for some reason.
They are a thing. They are a thing.
Guys, I'm just gonna Kermit now. I'll see you guys later.
Yeah, we may switch for Mubot, by the way, this weekend. Mubot's like very rudimentary as a bot. I want to get something a little more heft.
Yeah. Flavored popcorn would be amazing.
I'm sorry, I'm still trying to wrap my head around popcorn
flavored Tic Tacs. Yeah, I found cherry cola flavored Tic Tacs the other day. I'm sure that tastes like a mouth of barf.
These taste horrendous as well.
Do they? I don't.
Why are you eating them?
Because I saw them and thought, what the hell are those? I'll have to buy them. And then I bought them. I have to eat them because I bought them.
See, the thing is, like, Tic Tacs are supposed to be like breath fresheners. And I'm like, man, you know what I really want to go do? Is go on a date, have my breath smell like buttery ass popcorn. Get in there.
Well, I'm going to the movies. I'm going to smell like it anyway. I might as well just get rid of the breath right now and just get ready. Pre-show.
Pre-game the popcorn breath.
My God. You know what? Now you got Tic Tacs and that. I'm actually going to get some food, you know? As a muggle, I'm going to go grab something. I don't know. I'll be back in like 2 seconds.
Yeah, the worst part is they kind of... Once you bite them, they're really gritty. It's weird. Oh,
gross. Why are they gritty?
Don't know.
Like, I know Tic Tac.
Gotta get some of that Tic Tac popcorn grit.
Grit. Well, it's in my gums. It's still.
Isn't that a Dark Knight thing?
Grit?
Yeah.
I don't know if Tic Tac popcorn grit is the same grit.
I think this is now canon.
No, it's not.
Every time that a Dark Knight wants to get more hate, they just eat a whole bunch of these Tic Tacs, and it pisses everyone off so much.
Listen, I don't need that extra hate. I'd hate myself. I'd pop a bunch of Tic Tacs and throw myself off a fucking cliff.
No, that's the summoner's job.
I don't know. I just don't understand how he fell off Titan that many times.
I'm pretty sure he just needs to reroll as a Dragoon at this point.
He spent more time flying off.
Oh my god, there's banana-flavored ones as well.
Oh, artificial banana's the worst.
I don't know, some of them are great. Minion-flavored Tic Tacs.
Minion-flavored Tic Tacs.
That's the fuck?
Minions taste like bananas?
They like bananas, right? You are what you eat? I don't know.
Yeah, I'll put in Discord.
I eat bananas, Greg. Do I taste like bananas?
Oh god, I don't want to taste.
So with the whole Titan thing too, last night we were running Titan because someone needed a clear. I was running with the group from Behemoth again. And the entire time we were there, we had 7 people and 1 random, 7 of us in Discord doing stuff and actually organizing stuff. We didn't get the clear, but the entire time, all we could think about is, wow, Carrie really couldn't stay on the cliff.
Which fight were you guys doing?
It was Titan again.
Oh, you were doing Titan again?
We were doing Titan again to get someone else the clear. And Carrie wasn't even there, and all that we could talk about was the fact that he couldn't stay on the platform for that fight.
I really do blame his PC, though. He's running literally at the lowest.
They were inquiring as to when he was getting a new computer.
I have his parts behind my head. You could see them. They're like right up there. They're there, and the video.
Probably ship them.
I'm building the PC for him. He needs to send me the case. Actually, I may have a case for him too. He just needs to send me a power supply because that power supply in that case is old. And if he just sent me the money, he'd have it. Because I can get him a power supply like tomorrow.
What did you think of that video of me soloing Titans?
Chili, that's cheating.
That's not really cheating when you're on your own.
you just dodge.
Yeah.
Do you get stuck in the jail?
Yeah, you do.
How do you get out of that?
You just tank it, it explodes and does a bit of damage.
Oh, okay. You just tank it? Alright, good to know.
Does about 10,000 damage.
Is that how you get all your? Is that how you're doing your pony farms? Is that your pony farm solo just to get drops?
I did a few with my mate just to help him farm them. It was me and someone else.
Do they drop? Well, I know the drop rate's higher if you go at.
Yeah, it's they still drop though, but
just not as often.
But it's fun if you. I'd normally just do it when I've got my Wondrous Tales to do. It's that for the week. Me and my mate double warrior it normally.
Yeah, we got 1, 2.
It might sound easy, but it's not that easy soloing it, even unsynced.
I realize I can't count you and Chili, Paul. Paul, I can't count you or Chili and the people watching us. I was like, what? Oh wait. If Cred 13 though, that's new.
Hello, Cred13.
Hello, welcome.
I don't know if he's that new.
To watch him be like, he's like, bro, I've been here since day one.
Well, like, considering he joined our FC earlier.
Oh. You're watching us live now?
I'm sorry, we're a much bigger disappointment live.
They are not a disappointment. Don't listen to don't believe Shantor's lies.
What, you didn't know that Flatus actually goes through and edits the episodes before putting them up?
Yeah, I do. I do edit. He's right.
Granted, it's not removing any content, it's just making us sound better.
What he's planning to do this week, though, is anytime Lava Scorpion is mentioned, the audio speeds up.
The first time it says it, every time it says it, yeah, eventually. Actually, I'm just going to add the audio so that everything said is just Lava Scorpion. And then I'm going to put it to the beat of, hey, now you're an all-star. Shin is giving me the 5-minute mark.
I'll be so impressed if we can actually start on time today.
Yeah.
We had our 10 minutes of, oops, we need to figure this all out. We have everything set up. The audio levels seem good, chat. Yes, yes.
So far.
Oh, don't worry. As soon as we got the cameras hooked up, we were waving and I gave him the finger. Does that count?
He did. So, you know, there's that.
Much love from Canada.
Everyone in chat, I just want you to know, like, you're all like, damn, Canadians are so nice. And when I met Shin, like, some odd years ago, I don't know what happened. I think hanging out with me changed since.
Hanging out with every American, though?
Two years of watching Evercast, he was like, this guy's an asshole. And he's like, hey, Shin, go play Final Fantasy. This game's dumb. He's like, damn, I really like it. And then like, years later, now he's like hosting a show about Final Fantasy. He's like, well, might as well start flipping him off on camera when he starts streaming.
The downhill slippery slope from liking Final Fantasy to swearing at your co-host.
Yeah. It's a thing.
Me and Chili don't do that. Me and Chili have a loving relationship.
Wait, what? Klaus is like, my camera's not even on and I'm giving you the finger. Damn it!
To be fair, that relationship is different from the North American relationship. Giving each other the finger is just saying hello. It's only polite.
Did you learn this from the Mr. Bean movie where like somebody flipped him off and he thought that was how you said hi in America? He just started flipping everybody off.
Mr. Bean.
You know, I'm not sure if you're actually talking about a actual movie or if that's
It is an actual movie.
It is a movie.
Well, I know that Mr. Bean's a thing, and I just didn't know that that was actually part of the movie because it's completely believable that someone goes to America and believes that giving someone the finger is a hello. Because it pretty much is now.
Guess what I'm going to be doing?
Coming to America.
Please record reactions. Also, you might want to get a lawyer.
I am a lawyer.
I am the
American.
Law.
You need someone familiar with American law because even they don't understand it.
Wait. Hey. Listen.
Get wrecked.
Some of us know how the law works.
Are you sure?
Some of us just sign pieces of paper and hold it up and think we're very proud about what we're doing.
That's me.
I just want John Cena just to come out and just go, are you sure about that?
My favorite was the picture somebody posted of Trump at the Oval Office surrounded by the McMahons, and it said like just Stone Cold Steve Austin. Stone Cold Steve Austin fucking did like DDT or not DDT but
Stone Cold Stunner.
Yeah, stunned. He's like Stone Cold stunned 97% of this picture. Yep. 1 minute to going live. So all right. Well, you're gonna see it. You're gonna see these guys in the show. Shin's giving me the other finger, not the middle one. He's telling me 1 minute.
It was the one.
It was the one, I know.
I can see another finger. But it's not on your hands.
All right, I got 15 seconds. So I'm going to mute you guys. All right, say bye, stream.
Bye, stream.
Bye. Why was it? See you soon, stream.
Yeah, see you soon. All right, now they can't hear you guys. I can. I'm muting. All right, I'm ready to go. So this is it. Today is Monday, March 6th, 2017. It's episode 27.
All praise Lava Scorpio
of Maelstrom Radio.
Maelstrom Radio. With your hosts, Flatus and Shinder.
And welcome everybody to Maelstrom Radio. My name is Flatus, and we are. I have some hosts. I'm going to do some intros. This host has a husbando pillow of Alfie. It's Shin. This host's mom wants me to be her husbando. It's Paul Metal. Say hi, Paul.
I'm not saying shit now.
Yo, why? You know what's sad? I fucking had you guys muted like an asshole.
I even typed it into chat so that you wouldn't remember to unmute us.
That's fine. I did it. I forgot. It's okay, though. I'm pretty sure Paul said hi. Hi, Paul.
Thank you.
Don't worry.
I'm professional.
Don't worry. Because this host wants a waifu lava scorpion. It's Chili.
Hello.
Hi. If you haven't guessed by now, you need to put it. I love how Klaus in chat. You need to put it in the notes to unmute everyone, you imbecile. Why is everyone so spicy at me today? Hi. By the way, guys, if you don't know, we have Moogle Go Round Radio, the happiness. Happiness? The UK's number one Final Fantasy 14 podcast? That a thing? I'm saying it. I guess it is a thing now.
I guess we'll have to put it into our show.
Yeah.
Primal Flatus approved.
Yeah. Approved by a primal. So if you didn't know, the very first show that Shin and I guest hosted on was Moog Around. Paul found me in stream and was like, I like to go to check out smaller streams. I'm like, I do a podcast. And he's like, oh shit, you do? And then it just was uphill?
This goes downhill from there, no doubt.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I don't really know which direction that's going.
Was I fucking drunk at this point?
Were you? You don't? Yeah, I met you. You added me, and then you were like, come on our show. And I was like, okay. The very first show, it was you guys, plus Shin and I, and then Luna Vox.
That was a good time.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
We talked about Nando's. Got real silly on the show. And Nando's. It was a lot of Nando's talk in an episode. I think it was like 10% Final Fantasy 14 talk, 85% chicken talk, and then like another 5% of random bullshit.
To be fair, that's our shows in it.
So, I mean, was it cheeky? Yeah. It's always cheeky.
It's
It's always a cheeky Nando's.
Yeah. So, welcome to Maelstrom Radio.
Yeah, thanks for having us on.
Welcome, guys. So, we got a show for you. I don't know if it's going to be good or not, but it's going to be a show.
We can confirm there will be words.
There will be.
It might not be in sentences, but there will be words.
We've already, we prepped this beforehand. There might be certain words as well.
Yeah, there might, yeah. If you've ever seen George Carlin's The Seven Words You Can't Say on Television, listen, we may say nine. I don't know how many of those words you can say now, but we'll probably say them all. So let's jump into our normal routine. So as you know, we are recruiting for our FC on Fanfrit, Garuda Gang. If you enjoy this, then you'll enjoy talking to us and running stuff with us, and just the take what you find on the show and just put it to a live everyday thing. And that is our FC. Silverette Creed, welcome. You tweeted at me on Twitter and were like, yo, fan of the show, made an alt on Fanfrit and let me into that piece. I was like, all right. Sorry, I was out all weekend fixing computers at my grandmother's house, but Shin got you. I think we got you in.
I got this.
Yep. And we'll be playing with you this week, don't worry.
Oh, yeah, that doesn't sound pervert here at all.
No, it's not.
I was just going to leave that one.
You're just going to leave it?
In a bit, it's like, oh, yeah, we're going to play with you this weekend. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I figured Paul had it.
Yeah, just get real close to my... No? Yeah, everybody in chat just was like, ugh. And that's how we got our last episode on Twitch, because they were like, you guys can't make those noises. So thank you for joining. we're still doing a giveaway with YouTube for 100 follows on YouTube. Thank you to everyone that watches us on YouTube. I it's so amazing to go back and look. It's like, oh, there's like 15-20 views of our show. I can't tell if it's Donkatron just like watching us on repeat, or if it's or if it's actually like 20 individual people that go through and actually watch our show. But thank you, because I appreciate it. So
that's all he does while farming Umbrite.
Yeah, just watches us.
Oh, sorry, Light. He's farming Light now.
Yeah, that's right. So sometimes I have to repeat to remember. It's okay. We appreciate it. You're getting us views. Yeah, it's also how we get Klaus in chat. That's how we get our listens. Chili replays it 24/7. Chili, you're on the show. You shouldn't have to do that.
Now he's on our show, so he can help us with it too.
Yeah, no, Chili, are you gonna listen to two shows at once? You're gonna have to get a second phone or get an iPhone, or what do you have now? Just
I have an Xperia Z.
Okay,
I do need to upgrade.
Good choice.
Yeah,
I like my Android phones over iPhones.
All right, so this week we ran Dune Sky for the Proto Ultima. That was...
Which, yeah.
Our first time wasn't great.
Our first time, we had an amazing raid group that complained the whole time and then wiped a bunch and rage quit and boat abandoned.
Wait, did you guys wipe on Ultima?
We got to Ultima at...
We got to Ultima, and then our alliance rage quit and vote abandoned. The second time, however, we did get through and we killed it really easily.
It's just the first time I did it, everyone wiped. And every time I said that happened to me, everyone's like, oh, you can't wipe to that. How did you do that? Like, so I finally found someone who did as well. Finally. It's not just me.
Our second group, I don't know what happened. After that, the groups for the rest of that night were all really nice. Like, everybody was like, no, it's cool, don't worry, tanking. Like, I had one guy, because I like the wall, I've maybe gotten that in three times in roulette. That's it. Like, I've run what's it called, hard. So much
Samal hard.
Samal Hard so many times.
Get lava scorpions.
Lava scorpion normal.
I just call it, I just go in there now. I'm like, God damn it, lava scorpion again at this point.
I know, I've taken to every time that I run that dungeon, at the very end, just before we fight Lava Scorpion, I just yell out, praise Lava Scorpion.
Lava Scorpion, yeah.
So far, yeah. No one has responded, but I'm hoping it catches on.
One day,
when I was doing Dunscape last week, someone shouted out in the Alliance chat when they noticed it was me, praise Lava Scorpion.
I'm so happy about that.
I mean, it made me so happy.
It's kind of like the time when we were running Dunsky and we ran at Kinross Luna, and we just kind of both freaked out for a second and are like, we're running a raid with Luna. It was great.
Oh, yeah, and since my hosting name isn't the same as my character name in Final Fantasy, like, I have to tell people, like, now you know the secret. So if you didn't know, my in-game name isn't Flatus, it is Cypher Blackfire. So if you didn't know that, now you know. Is it? I'm sorry. Shin highlighted this just so, and he's making sure I see it. Is that Flatus is slow and Umbrite. Slow or patient? Because I waited for Nurse and I got done with the first bar in no time. Just saying.
Slow because I already finished the first bar and the second bar, and I'm on the next step now.
I'm halfway through my second Umbrite. Yeah, my second weapon.
I'm on my third light.
But listen.
It was bad, man.
You were both insane.
Yeah, I can't. It's okay. I was patient. I waited for nerfs. Some people are like, did it before the nerf? Guess what? I'm like, did it at nerf. Here's my little badge. At nerf. Alright, Thornmar GX is dead. Long live Moogle King.
I finally cleared Thornmarch. You weren't there for our lovely cure, but I finally did.
Okay, congratulations.
Why did you kill our king? Nah, it's fucking blasphemy. Now, Jilly, we're leaving.
Our king is Lava Scorpion. Sorry, that's our god. Yeah. I don't think Moogles worship Lava Scorpion, though.
No, they don't. It's fine. We can just get another one. It's okay.
No, they do because they live in the same area.
The other Moogles.
Not wrong.
Is that one a king, though? Lives in a giant... I mean, it sits in a giant dandelion.
I thought that was, like, their current king.
Is that their current... Is it their current king? I'm very confused about Moogle lore.
Like, our former king, our former god king that raised up to the earth to save the mortals.
We have to get Sarah on the show just for, like, Moogle chat.
Yeah, we need that. We need expertise.
We need to borrow Klaus's Lord Barian just to have him on an episode and talk nothing about Moogles and how they drink chocolate wine to get drunk.
No. You should take him and talk about Maelstrom. We should take him and talk about Moogles. When Moogle go
That's
around
true. Later.
He would. Oh, listen. If we're gonna talk about the Maelstrom.
No. Look.
I also want to give a quick shout out to the group on Behemoth that we randomly found in. Party Finder and running Titan a couple weeks ago, and that's who actually we ran through and cleared Thornmarch with, and they're just awesome people, and yeah.
Once we get cross-server SCs, I'm going to absorb them from Behemoth into us slowly, Garuda Gang will slowly move across to all servers. It'll be like a plague.
We are the Borg.
Good thing you're not getting to Phoenix.
Yeah!
You have to face the Omega Knights.
Yeah, it's like the Borg.
The Borg.
Yeah, assimilate.
My god.
I'll let you figure that out. News, Little Ladies Day. I shouldn't have said assimilate and then start Little Ladies Day.
So you did all this, last week. Done, well, safe, you're wiped, you know, you need to get good, need to kill it first time. Flatus, you're slow at Relic.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that was our last week.
Mm-hmm.
But actually, with the Dunscape thing, actually, were you very disappointed in Proto?
If based on what we played at FanFest, I kind of wish, if they made it so that he would move around, like, it was a repeatable quest, but he just moved. Like, oh, now he's in here, but I understand why they put him in Dunsky. Yeah, I kind of am. Like, I am a little bit. I kind of wish it was a little harder. And
I'm
going to
say,
as
much as we are disappointed in it, at FanFest, we were all high level 250. Now a lot of people at high level 260 plus to 270. So that doesn't help with the difficulty of adding him into Dunsky when it already has to be a certain high level anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, it kind of, I don't know, to me it feels like they, like, it was cool jumping over and seeing that, oh shit, it's Proto Ultima, and that was kind of like a nice little surprise, but like cool in shock matter, like the shocking aspect of it, like, oh cool, that was really cool how they like implemented him and where they implemented it, or it, but I would say difficulty and compared to what we played, I don't know. Like, it just felt lackluster.
I just didn't like it. It was just a massive light show. I didn't find it hard. It was just like, okay, I preferred Slug Woman over Proto Ultima because I thought she gave a bit more of a shot and she was a bit more tankier.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, it definitely felt kind of zergy.
Yeah. It wasn't as hard as the previous fight in there. I mean, well, I guess you could still do it if you don't do the quest. Or is he in there? Has anyone checked if he's in, if Proto Ultima's in there, regardless if you have the quest?
Yeah, because my FC leader didn't have the quest and it was there, so.
Oh, wow.
Well, not
okay.
FC leader, but party leader, sorry. Because we were doing raids beforehand, and she said, oh, yeah, we'll do Dunsky now. I said, okay, go get the Ultima quest. She said, okay. So we waited about 15 minutes. I said, oh, yeah, okay, I'm back now. Let's queue. I said, okay. Got in there. Oh, she said, oh, yeah, I forgot to pick it up again.
Yeah.
That sounds familiar.
Flatus, probably.
No, not Flatus.
No, not
Flatus. No. Another Curry.
We queued again, and she forgot again.
Is your leader also our summoner? Just out of curiosity.
I love her, but yeah.
Not only does he fall off Titan every single time, but when we ran it twice, he forgot both times to actually pick up the quest to complete Titan, so he couldn't come and join us on Ifrit. No, he had to run Titan a third time because he, again, yeah.
Yeah. My favorite was that he picked up the quest to unlock Titan and then abandoned the quest for whatever reason.
Wow.
Yeah, and then ran it. It was kind of-
And then he ran it, didn't have the quest, realized it after. Then he went and picked up the quest, forgot to touch the etherite, and ran it again, completed it, and then had to do it a third time because he, yeah.
Like, he knows that fight. Right, he still falls off. All right, so.
One mechanic.
Yep.
All right, Little Lady Day started last week, and it's going until March 14th. So go ahead, and it's a quick thing to get your Songbird emote, and that emote is ridiculous.
Gotta have more dances.
Yeah, it's a dance.
It looks like a mix like the Carlton or the dance from Fantasy X-2, Real Emotion.
It is. I was gonna say it's very Feel the Motion.
Yeah.
It's very
Vocaloid.
Yeah, it is. It's very like Hatsune Mitsu. Like, it's very, yeah. That.
I'm not a giant weeb.
I was gonna say, weeb pop music.
K-pop, but weeb pop music.
Weeb pop.
I tried that in VR. It's weird.
I feel like. So just go ahead and do it. It's a quick little fun little thing. Just get an emote. So it's on it. And they also give you 5 cards so you can just instantly get the whole gear set, the glamour. So it's quick. It takes you no time to get all the stuff. Bright Eyed Superstars Contest. This is pretty straightforward. Take a screenshot of up to 8 of your cherished companions as you show off your most glamorous side to dazzle all of Eorzea. Now this sounds like the perfect contest for Miss Luna Vox. I think she'd like doing this. Listen, if I get 8 of our members to sit there and try to dazzle Eorzea, it's not going to look pretty. it's not going to be a thing.
It's going to look ugly.
You can enter the entry periods from March 3rd until March 17th. Up to 15 winners will win a glamour item. Within those 50, up to 3 will win a grand prize of one set of the Taito figurines. It's Giustola, a Hard Chiffon, and the Payasa. And
North America only.
Is it? Oh, it's I'm sorry. NA only. I'm sure that this contest will also probably pop up in the EU.
It won't at all. We always get fucking forgetting because NA best, you know. Don't care about EU. You got me salty now.
I'm not saying go to the forums and drop the salt there, but that's where I would go and be like, how come they got all the cool contests and we didn't get shit? Also, we had to pose naked with magazines to get our white fat chocobos. And I'm not sure why I had to be naked for that, but Final Fantasy. Yeah. Final Fantasy 14 at PAX East. I'm a little jealous. Here's the thing. I'm pissed. I'm a little pissed at the people going to listen. Not because you're going to PAX East, by all means have fun. I'm pissed off because you get a t-shirt for going and doing the Warring Triad challenge. We didn't get one shirt at FanFest, and you go to PAX East and you're just like, yeah, just do this Warring Triad challenge and you get a shirt.
Yeah, that pissed me off so much.
I'm salty about that shit. And it's a sweet Stormblood shirt.
It's not
cool, bro.
Well, it's like there was an event just before FanFest. I can't remember what event it was, but they had like bajillion t-shirts, didn't they? They had one for PV, two for PvP, three challenges. There was something else, if I'm right. There was three t-shirts, and that was only like a couple of weeks or so before FanFest.
Yeah. Was it PAX West, maybe? It was PAX West, I think, at that point.
Yeah.
So,
if you go to PAX, you'll get more stuff than you will at their FanFest.
Yeah. Go to PAX. Get shirts. Or was it Classes Gamescom? They had tons of t-shirts there. Gamescom. Yeah.
I should have gone.
You should have. They probably would have paid for your way there. Gotten you in. Wink nudge next time, maybe. All right, so speaking of I don't know what my transition is for this.
Speaking of Stormblood.
Speaking of paying your way. No?
How does that transition into that?
No, bad.
That was terrible.
Alright.
Oh yeah, there's a Warring Triads thing at PAX East, win a Stormblood t-shirt. If you do it, you know, that's pretty good. We're talking about Stormblood, we've just got some new information.
Oh, there you go. Listen, these guys
do our segues.
Fuck God, we fucking suck. What happened? We used to not be good, and we used to get worse.
That's because we joined the show today.
All right. There's new Stormblood information from the Dengeki. Listen, Shin, if I say this wrong, please correct me. But I'm gonna say it's
Dengeki. No, I'm just gonna sit here and enjoy it.
Oh, is it not Dengeki? Is it Dengeki?
That would probably be closer.
Alright. I'm gonna say Dengeki interview. Someone in chat's gonna flip shit. Someone listening to the show is gonna be like this.
No, we're just enjoying this.
Oh, thanks. Changes to parry, accuracy, blocking, piety, etc. coming in 4.0. Details to be determined.
Yes.
Yep.
Yay.
Yes, this is so we're starting to get some of the news rolling in about the changes to our stats and our skills and stuff as we're rolling past the fan fest. So I think we're gonna get these are the changes coming soon. Company crafting getting updates, maybe submarines. Oh, Shin, we can build submarines.
And they can be yellow. Hopefully.
Yes. Listen, Shin, this is all we got to do, right? We build one giant yellow submarine, right? And we just take a bunch of shrooms and just see where we end up.
Oh my God.
So, you do know that requires crafting, right?
Which one? The mushrooms?
Both.
No, that requires gathering.
Yeah, no. The mushrooms, you need a high level crafting, so you get a high quality version.
Oh, okay. Cook, it's fine.
Why wouldn't you need a high gathering skill to gather high quality versions?
Because you don't want to just find any old mushrooms out in a cow patty. You got to make sure you're getting good quality mushrooms.
Good quality, nice mushrooms.
You need the high quality crafters to put them into food. You sneak them in.
By the way, Maelstrom Radio is probably not for the faint of heart and parental advisories. Middle, put that in the middle of the show.
Ain't no cows you need to get out of it, mate.
Yeah. New tank mounts. I'm gonna get a new mount. I haven't got my first one yet, but I'm gonna get a new one.
I'm kind of disappointed with the new tank mounts because I would really like to have some mounts for other classes. And I know they're just trying to encourage tanks to actually like have people tank, but
I absolutely agree that healers need mounts. I think they do. I think they deserve it just as much as tanks. I mean, especially going into this expansion with two DPS extra, I think you want to get people to want to, yo, like, come heal.
Before anyone says anything, I know the white mages have a unicorn. I don't consider that a proper mount.
Why?
It is a mount, but like it but doesn't compare proper to some of the warrior and the Dark Knight and Paladin ones.
Just because it's got four clippity clops doesn't mean it's a fucking proper mount.
But no, this is stupid. Like, makes me stupid because if you don't have a decent healer, you're not going to be fucking tanking for very long. That's unless you're flattest, and you know the healers can't really do much about that.
No, Creed, not a fairy mount. We want a giant book for Scholar.
What, like they're in the Wizard of Oz?
If they're in the Wizard of Oz, they'd have a hot air balloon.
And then Astro Odin should just get a giant star.
and just on the back of it, it says, "More you know." Or the more we know going on the back of it.
You know those like gravity machines that people put themselves in the middle of and they spin around in all different directions, like so they don't barf and get to feel a G-force on their body?
Oh, you mean what they do for like, was it like astronauts?
Yeah, like for like space camp and stuff?
Yeah.
Just get astrologians one of those and they have to ride in the middle, but they're always spinning around in all sorts of different directions. Oh my God.
So basically you want another turtle.
Except...
No.
Except the astrologians in the middle of it, like holding on for dear life and just spinning in all sorts of different directions, going, ah!
See, I had the same sort of idea first in a way, but I was thinking of a giant globe instead.
Or like a giant hamster ball? Like a giant hamster ball?
This is why Flatus can't design mounts.
Why? Because I'd give him a hamster ball.
Hey,
People would buy it.
I put little bells on it.
It'd be easy for them to do as well. They could just reskin the ads mount.
Yeah. Never give us a furry-esque like style. Like you put the cat in there, the Mikote. Maybe the Venna. Like put a rabbit girl in there, bunny girl.
All I can see is my Lalafell in there.
I don't know, but we can't take this too far towards furry animal creatures.
Chili, then it's like putting a potato in the Tupperware.
But I actually want to point on a note that I think it was in the live letter. I don't know if they were joking about this, but giving us an umbrella mount?
Yes, I remember seeing about that. It'd be like Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins. I grew up in Mary Poppins. Mary Poppins was probably one of my favorite movies as a kid. Same with Sound of Music. And I really want to be Mary Poppins. I don't care. I want to be a giant Rogadin flying on an umbrella.
I want the umbrella to be super tiny. Like,
talking.
Like Wile E. Coyote tiny, where it's like giant boulder, tiny umbrella, but then you fly around like holding this tiny little umbrella above your head. Like, no matter the size.
It has to have a talking little parrot on it. Like, some more bird.
Some little bird on it? Like Iago from...
Paul knows what I'm talking about.
Or instead of doing that flat, just have it so that the mount is the same size no matter what. Have it designed for a Lalafell, but have the mount be the same size, no matter what race you play
in. We should have multiple mounts for each race, but each race can use all of the different umbrellas. So a Lalafell could use the Rogadin mount, but also the Rogadin mount, or the Rogadin could use the Lalafell mount.
All the Lalafell is going to do is just grab on and be like, yeah, I'm off.
Or just reverse the sizes of the mounts, like Rogadins automatically get the Lalafell size one, and then Lalafells get the giant Rogadin one. So if you want an average size one, you have to pick like a Makote. Because I think it would be hilarious, like one giant Rogan and tiny little umbrella. All right, there's no Grand Company in Kugane, but different organizations. So Yakuza?
No, the Yakuza!
I really hope not, but this kind of sounds interesting. Like, they're not bringing another Grand Company into things, which I think is a good idea. There's three already, and we don't really need a fourth for PvP factions. We don't need a fourth for everyone to switch over to that and start grinding stuff from that. So yeah, it'll be kind of interesting to see what do they bring that's going to be probably similar in concept, but a different implementation.
Do you think that's how it's going to affect our PvP going forward, is the organizations? Like, there'd just be two of them? I don't know. No?
They could probably do that. Like, they got the like different organizations, trading, security, like all that, like gathering materials. Like, I think they would have that in a certain way where this is how you'd be able to level your crafting up, and possibly, I say possibly, you know, learn fighting skills, or it could be like another version. They could do a whole lot of things with that. Like, one could be like mass crime. Like, just different organizations.
Yeah.
Because
Yakuza.
Yeah, Yakuza. And I can already see an FC already making the Yakuza clan, and, you know...
Don't give him any ideas.
Garuda Gang. We're already halfway there.
Yeah, just actually need a few more people.
Yeah. Oh.
I'm calling it now. If there is a Yakuza gang, and if there is any bad people in it, they'll all be Lalafells, because we're always evil.
That is true.
True.
Although I would really like to see something like, they've talked about adding more reputation systems in, and we're kind of seeing this with Chloe added there. Or not Chloe.
Zoe.
Thank you. And with all of that in there, we're seeing being able to build up reputations and stuff like that. So I'm hoping that maybe we'll see some organizations that also follow this. And we don't have the concept so much of competing organizations or diametrically opposed organizations. So it's not like, hey, I'm going to get up faction with you guys, but I can't, and I lose it with the other ones. But just having the ability to get up faction, kind of like the Beast Tribes, would be interesting.
Yeah, like, but with the Beast Tribes, I don't know if you guys have done all the Beast Tribes, you know, the Vanu, Varth, and Moogle.
No.
But when you do get a quest, like, I'm not going to spoil for it, but I think what the organization is going to be is that I think this is going to be like a side quest for it. It's basically a little bit like Hildebrand, in that where you actually have to earn reputations with these organizations. And then at some point, you're going to move them towards everyone getting along. Because they're probably not going to, you know, they're not going to get along, obviously, because it's a tendency, like, one company hates this company hates that company. It's just a rivalry between organizations that we're going to have to fix, obviously, as the Warrior of Light. We have to do fucking everything in this goddamn world, because, you know, everyone else hasn't got a right mind into doing so. So I think they're going to have that, but also with the reputation system in, so you can get cool items, or like one's gonna be for gathering, one's gonna be for crafting. I think that would be pretty cool, because then that would give me something to do. I would work on that for ages.
Unless you're near Toscavia, because then we're gonna find out. Listen, we watched that trailer a couple times. Nero's just like, go ahead, send in your Warrior Light like you always do. I hope that's gonna change coming this expansion. I hope that he's the guy that's like, yo, you guys rely way too much on that dummy.
I just hope with this new system that I be able to get waifu. That'd be amazing.
Lava Scorpion waifu?
Lava Scorpion waifu.
But you already had a waifu in game.
Yeah, but an NPC one on the side.
So you want a mistress?
Yeah.
But I already have one. I have my little Lalafell Materia Mender. She's fine.
You already got a wife in the game. Yeah, but I want an NPC one on the side. Chili, you'd fit in right in here. Like, just come to America. There was a website where a bunch of guys got busted for that. There's a bunch of side chicks up in Canada.
No, but it's much preferable than going to the America right now.
Oh.
Probably easier with the whole like UK Canada thing.
We all have the same queen, so.
I was just making sure because I thought, like, if you want a side chick, Canadian ladies.
I mean, why not?
But why can't you have a side guy?
Listen, whatever your flavor is.
Both, because you know, I love both. Side. That's how I lost my virginity. It was so good.
Whole sides?
Whole sides.
All sides. All right. Speaking of sides. Gilgamesh.
He does like his swords.
Yeah, speaking of guys who fall through holes, Gilgamesh. he might appear in the 4X series.
That's good because Gilgamesh is awesome.
Yeah, so I don't think he'll show up as a part of Hildebrand. Which would be sad, because I think that interaction between Greg and Hildebrand is hilarious.
I just want to see Hildebrand, like, pass it off to someone else so that he's continued to be called Greg in 14.
Oh my god, please? I hope it's a change of dialogue, that if we completed Hildebrand, we could refer to him as Greg. No matter where he is, that he's like, oh hey, and you're like, hey Greg.
Oh yes. Greg, let's go.
Please let that be a thing. By the way, if you've not done Hildebrand, please go do that.
I need to finish the new Hildebrand. I just didn't want to
hear it. It's great. The ending is great.
I can say now that I haven't done the Dragon's Neck. I know what you guys are saying. I was leaving it for a very special occasion where I just wanted to sit down and do Hildebrand. But then I got sidetracked with obviously making a podcast, to raiding, to switching server, to fuck my life, I don't know what I'm doing anymore. But I'm probably going to get around to it, probably just coming up for the expansion so it gives me something to do.
Stream can't see all the hand signals I'm making, but it's effectively get out.
Oh.
I can see them.
I was like, what the fuck is he telling me right now? I'm like looking around, I'm like, is there something wrong? What is he seeing that I'm not seeing? I'm like trying to put out a fire and I'm like, just tape it to me someplace. I was like,
no, you'll know if something's on fire.
I was like, wow, this show's going pretty smooth, and all of a sudden he's like making hand signals and shit. I'm like, what the fuck's on fire?
It's a trap.
Thanks, Shin. Shin just wanted to tell everybody to get out, I guess.
Well, if you insist, like, it's like, what is it, coming up for my bedtime, so if you want me to go, I can just...
No, you're good. I mean...
Bed's just there, I can have the mic on, you can hear me snore.
No.
So it doesn't make sure that I'm alone.
Again. No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
I almost always forget about that until it happens.
Oh, that fucking gave me a heart attack! Oh my god! Someone called help! Satan, I'll deal with you later.
So.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Speaking of things that fell.
Oh!
Speaking of things that crashed and burned.
Oh. Speaking of things that need liberating.
Oh my god.
Alamigo and Doma fell for lots of reasons. Wait for main story. This is from the Famitsu interview that Yoshi P did. So, I mean, there's apparently a lot of reasons why it fell. What, you know,
wasn't just because the Garleans had superior might. Like, it wasn't just because they were really powerful. There were other reasons.
Was it because they forgot to take the right medication?
Yeah.
It's someone could let the chocobo out.
When they find each other, and that's because it happened, they're too busy finding each other, and the Garleans were sort of funding them with weapons, and then one side won, and then Garleans just came in and finished them off.
Well, I mean, what was it? Gaius Van Belsar took over Alamigo with no bloodshed. So, I mean, to me, that speaks like there's some weird shit going on with like the royalty there that he can come in and come in.
It's the Yakuza.
Is it?
We'll know. It'll be some sort of magical Allegan tech that did it.
Yeah.
Please no. But enough of the goddamn Allegans.
Yeah, they created like a. You know that bird?
It's on the moon base.
Yeah. You know that bird that you put in front of a cup of water and it like tips and goes forward and drinks water and then comes back up and wobbles a little bit and then tips again and drinks water? He put that in front of the Alamigans and they're all like fascinated by it. And he just like Gaius Van Belsar came up behind them and overthrew them and he was like, ha ha!
Hypnosis.
He's like, ha ha! Garlean technology.
What's this thing? It's like, I'm king now. I'm king of this rock.
Yeah.
And it says, fuck you, motherfucker.
He's like, behold my drinky bird. And everybody's like, oh, drinky bird.
You magnificent bastard, you read my book.
Yeah. Othard is based on Orient and Asia in general, not just Japan. So we'll get a good healthy mix of, like visuals and landscapes and different architect and styles going through authored. Alamigo, I think, like that area, I think it will be more Middle Eastern based from what I could tell. So, go ahead.
If we're going to like Orient or Asia, what does it look like? Is that the beginning of America? Because they're building a wall. Well, there's a wall being built. Is that like?
Pretty sure that other countries have built walls before America did.
Yeah, we have.
I know that China has. I know like the castle has. You know, but
England has a massive wall already. We've had it for years.
Have we? Where's that?
It's outside of England. It's just look it up.
Paul, look up. Just look up. You can't miss it. Paul turns around, giant wall behind him. He's like, God damn! What? Chili's like, it's been behind you this whole time.
Is that like the demon wall?
Yeah.
And
it's like the angel from Doctor Who. He hasn't been looking at it, so it's slowly moved towards him.
It's like the hand from Dun Sky.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, it used to be a fence. I can't remember where it's just outside of England. In between England and France.
Oh, sort of thing. Yeah.
But they turned it into a wall recently, so.
We
did it first.
Yeah, we first, motherfuckers. Actually, I think China did it first, actually, with the Great Wall of China.
They were trying to keep up the Mongols. Yeah, that was.
The Mongrels.
One hell of a wall.
Yeah,
Hadrian built a wall. There you go, see?
Yeah, I was going to say Elton
John. We're very good at building walls.
Many walls.
To be honest, with the speed our builders make stuff, they probably started making this wall back then as well, and they've only just finished it.
So, like, the first
ancient
half is just
ancestors.
First part of the wall's all stone, and the last part of the wall's all, like, metal beams, and it's like, well, now we gotta go back to the first end of the wall and fix it.
On my road, it took them three weeks to paint the road with a yellow stripe.
Oh my god, I do hate those here. So, like, yeah. It takes so long to do those.
You should just go and do it yourself.
Okay.
You just don't like yellow paint, or?
I also had the stairs repaired, you know, outside my flat. It's about six stairs. Took them 2 months.
You know, stairs take a long time to build. I just like it how like this has got very confused, and then all we see is just flatters.
Anyway, we better get back on target. Sorry.
Seeing their like webcams, they're like, "What the fuck are they on about?
Yeah,
it's... What the fuck are these guys doing? Are they on drugs? They're talking about building and walls."
Yeah,
anyway, no, we better get on.
You know,
it's
that
a lot,
you know...
tamer than what we usually talk about. So,
what? Yeah. Doesn't blow like what?
Did you not listen to episode 1 through 26? It's been nothing but hookers and blow.
They're come back.
Yeah, there will be player hubs in Idle Like Isleshire, but with a twist. So, the twist is hookers and blow.
Oh, damn.
So, can't wait is what's written there. The Island of Val will be important in the main story. What is the Island of Val?
The Island of Val. And I'm like, no, that's Steam.
No, the Island of Val is where Kryle, if I remember, if Kryle came from. She's the lone survivor. Yes, I'm gonna say yes. Kryle. So, you know,
well, as far as we know, I don't think we ever heard the information of what happened.
Yeah, we don't. We just know that
we know something went wrong. But we don't know what.
Yeah. Dogatron in chat. Yes, Kryle, lone survivor. Thanks, Donk. Donk's hold it down.
Lone Survivor, good movie.
Lone Survivor. Good to know. Let's see. Let's housing. House moving system will not work for apartments. So, you know, get wrecked.
So, I like my apartment.
Yeah.
I don't
can you just buy another one because they're not exactly super expensive.
Yeah. And the Sam Sense system, the Samurai Sense system, is new, similar to monk stances and not at all like ninja's mudras. So we'll see how that plays when it actually is released.
I kind of like that. Sorry, go ahead, Paul.
No, it's your show. Don't take me there.
Just gonna say, I kind of like that idea. Like I find the ninjas mudras are a little bit much, mostly because I haven't paid attention to them and I've just started playing the ninja. Not having them right off the top of my memory, it kind of is a pain to remember them. It's a really cool system. I'm just not quite sure how well it plays into this game. Whereas the monk stances, I think, are a little bit easier to pay attention to. You can still swap them between depending on what you want to do, but it gives a little bit less that you have to think about. So having the new system be similar to that and not like the mudras is, I think, going to help a lot.
Dogatron in chat, 4 buttons to do one thing.
But the Sen system with the monk stance, though, it's just going to be basically you get the other, you get some tankiness. That's pretty much what the monk stances are. So if they're just going to implement to that, then fine. But they're only going to use the monk. They're only basically just going to use damage and occasionally the tanky one. So it's not really that bad.
Well, they could always have one that's maybe like, this is for burst DPS. This one's for AoE DPS. This is for defense. Like they could spread it out a little bit more as well if they wanted.
I think, yeah, like then you have to like switch over between like the fights you're playing. Like, yeah, getting that burst stance first, burst, and then go into like just normal rotation, but in a different stance.
I think that would give some interesting playstyles to the class, though, right? Like, if you had to switch between burst DPS, AoE DPS, like, you'd be okay for certain specific things, but depending on how you played or how you switched between or adjusted to the situation, you could do that much better or that much worse. It'd be kind of cool to see if you actually had a stance that maybe adjusted your abilities completely so that in one version, all of your abilities were single target. In another one, they're all AoE, but they're a lot less powerful. And
that would be interesting. If they could pull that off, then I think that would be really good. I'd like to see that happen.
So, ignoring Twitch chat.
But you didn't have to ignore it. You could just.
A lot of things happened over there. Let's see. Game Watch interview with Yoshida. Classes. New role shared actions will remove the need for class-specific support skills. Sam and Red Mage will use new system. That obvious.
So... Enough of blood?
Yeah.
So, it's not necessarily that they're going to remove blood for blood, but it's that right now blood for blood is basically all DPS need this ability to kind of maximize their potential. And they want to move away from having these class-specific things. You shouldn't have to level all the classes to max in order to get abilities to play one class. So instead, they're going to implement like these role shared actions. So all DPS will have a set of actions available to them. So if you level up your bard, you'll have blood for blood as part of that already.
Okay, so in other words, they're getting rid of Dragoon completely. Dragoon is not needed no more, guys. So just don't play it.
But who's
still need?
I was going to say, who's going to occupy the floor?
Who still needs tanking?
We all went for the floor joke. I felt that was maybe too easy.
Yeah, but we can.
It was. That's why you all took it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, let's be honest. They're not getting a pet. Come 4.0. No wyverns for dragoons. Although ninja may get a falcon. So how about a big old fuck you to dragoons? Oh, we heard you guys wanted some sort of like flying pet. Dragoon's like, oh my god, and all of a sudden it's like, ninjas get a falcon. You're like, fuck.
But what I kind of find it funny though is that I want to see what these classes do. Samurai and Red Mage, I want them to see if they replace like Summoner and Black Mage, or is like, are we just going to get rid of like a certain DPS role? Because I know right now the merit is Dragoon, Ninja, Summoner, or Black Mage with a... Well, actually, no. Summoner, Black Mage, or Machinist, and a Bard. That is the DPS meta right now.
I think the idea going forward for them is not to keep the meta. It's to make everything viable going forward. Because the hardest thing for any MMO is to make every class... Like, you don't want anyone to feel like I'm the weak class and it's the class I like to play. So now I'm forced to play something else that I don't necessarily like to play, but I have to play in order to compete or play with other people doing the content I like to do.
You go tell my monk that right now. Like a lot of us have been like, oh, like, you know, having a joke saying, oh, you should play ninja, you know, ninja's better for this monk, but he's always top DPS and I don't really care. Like, you know, I like to see in the top deeps from a monk. So yes, they got no rage utility yet.
Hey, I have all the rage utility. I have
Yeah.
I'm good now.
You have mantra. That's really.
You heal yourself already, so I guess you.
I punch things really hard. There we go.
The idea, I think, in the long run, is to try to make it so that, in behind the scenes, mathematically, it'll all even out in the end, which could be really hard, or they have, that's why they're doing it this route. To me, like, when you play something like World of Warcraft and like the first couple, like the first part of the game or at launch of an expansion, everybody's like, all right, cool, I'm playing my classes, everything. And all of a sudden, like, when they release, and they may say something, oh, like, no, everything's perfect, there's not gonna be nerfs, and they go and release nerfs, it could instantly break classes, which happens a lot in WoW. Things get broken and the people like instantly have to change and switch classes because now they're not doing the same DPS or the heals or you're giving me this look like the audio just fucked up. Is it fucked up still? No, right.
Why does Flash sound like a robot?
Yeah, I think the Discord is making you sound terrible to all of us.
Alright, no, it's cool.
Oh good, if it's okay, there we go.
I can fix that.
Yeah, there we go.
Look, see, that's instant. I got it. Robot Flatus, that's fine. Listen, I can cut that out of the show.
So, Flatus is actually secretly a cyborg Lalafell.
Maybe. Wait, what?
Wait, cyborg Lalafell Primal. That's weird.
Yeah, no.
It's potatoes.
I'm not potato sized.
Fucking do it.
I'm not. Much larger.
Why, you're a primal?
That's what he
potato.
Said?
But is that why you say I'm a primal potato? Great King Moogle Spud.
That's terrible. Also, can someone please Photoshop that?
You're so welcome. You're welcome, internet, for that one.
Well, I know what I'm doing tonight after the show.
So yeah, in the longer, what I was trying to say, sorry about the robot. What I was trying to say is that there, behind the scenes, they'll probably work it out mathematically so that everything fits into place, so that everything is viable, because you still want to be able to have people play it. Like, I love playing Dragoon, or I love playing Ninja, or I love playing Samurai, or whatever it's going to be. You don't want a flavor of the month to happen, because you'll just have too many people coming in and being like, I want to play Ninja, or I want to play this. And then the meta will consistently change, and that's not great for rating, because then you'll have people like that's already a Ninja, and then if Ninja becomes really good, then you're gonna have people all wanting to switch to Ninja, and then your meta, your statics break apart that way, and things get fucked, and it's not good.
But at the same time, like, they're trying to do this for the majority of the gamers, so not necessarily then are definitely not the people who are like out there raiding and doing all of that. Like, they will try to balance it so that the DPS meta is pretty reliable and you could have all the classes you want, but there's always going to be a class that's going to be that much better than the others, even if it's just by a margin. So it's not like we're just going to, there's going to be new classes released and everyone is going to switch to them because, yeah, they're new classes, it's something new. But this will probably change the meta, but not so much in a way that, like, the meta is going to change always. So there will always be a flavor of the month class. There's always going to be a class that's going to do better than another one. There's always going to be classes that some statics will want to run with and others that they won't want to run with. There's nothing that they can really do to fix that short of making every single class identical, which defeats the purpose.
Yeah. So we'll see. I mean, I kind of wish that they push the changes before the expansion so we can get one used to the changes, and to test it, I guess, so that if they do need to make small adjustments, they can make it prior to the expansion launch.
I think actually they will do it prior to the expansion, just because we do know that there's already going to be a head start starting on 4 days ahead. So they can't have it such that all the players don't have access for 4 days, or that the players who have access beforehand have new abilities that the others do not. So I have a feeling that we'll get combat and some other changes in a patch prior to the expansion launching. And then with 4.0, the pre-launch time, it'll be before that.
I hope all you guys have took days off for that.
Not yet, but just because I haven't sent a message.
Yeah, that's all I have to do, so just schedule the time. Yeah, Friday, I already know I have to work a little bit because they've already told me that I have to.
Well, I was actually thinking that we get like a couple of podcasts just on Discord while we're playing it, if they've all got like the days off, and just sit there and play it.
And get like. I'm planning to do the Friday through the Monday.
I'm Friday part of the day through Monday through the rest of the week, so I may be dead by next the following Friday. I may just be a husk in a chair. So we'll see.
Husk in a chair. Same here.
Moving forward, there's more to Authored and then Doma, Hingashi, and Azim Steps, but no more info. So some of that clouded map, we may see more of it?
Possibly, maybe. Maybe. I doubt it, though.
Just make an awkward noise. total area is about the same as Heavensward, but also diving and swimming in unannounced areas. Teleports, money is likely going to be less than. They're going to try to keep it under 999 gil. So I got 999 problems, but going over 1,000 gil ain't. I'm so glad someone laughed, because Shin was sure as fuck wasn't going to laugh at that. I'm gonna have them more on. I'm gonna have them on more often. You don't laugh. They do.
I'm like trying to watch four different screens right now.
Isn't it great?
Same.
So this was kind of weird how they worded it, and I'm not quite sure if the total areas. They said the total areas is the same as Heaven's Word, but also diving and swimming and unannounced areas. Does that mean that the expansion 4.0 is going to be the same size in addition to diving and swimming, or is the diving and swimming included in the same size expansion?
If they want me to pay 999 gil to swim, that'd be annoying.
You'd have to pay to swim, I don't think.
No, it's the travel to use the Aetherite traveling.
Yeah, it's the Aetherite that they're going to be expensive because you know you're traveling across continents, but they're going to make it less than 1,000 gil.
Yeah, but also if you guys have FCs, you'll have reduced rates on anyway, so that'll go down like a couple of gil. So
yep. That assumes that we actually have that running.
Yeah, flat.
I can. Yo, everybody's got the ability. A lot of people got that ability to set things off on that piece. All right, so
it's true. I do as well.
Yeah. So
I just don't.
Yeah, it just doesn't do. Dogtron though. Dogtron in chat. Thanks, buddy. Constantly, always putting up the leveling boost for everybody that's always currently leveling in RFC. So thanks, buddy.
I'm glad that's the direction you went.
Yeah. Which one do you think I was gonna go with?
You had the whole other conversation you already responded to. Wasn't sure if that was gonna make the podcast.
The piece about the blood cloth and the piece after the blood cloth. That
yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's where I draw the line there.
Well, I mean, you know, trying to maintain a healthy weight loss goal.
Oh my god, here we go with that.
Speaking of things that players have found. Hey, I had the opportunity and I took it there.
You should have. No, go ahead.
Players have found, I'm going to butcher these, but Genvu, Byakko, Seiru, I can't say it. And
That's a translation.
Like Ho-Oh, the Pokemon.
That's a translation error.
Yeah. Oh,
anyways, they found all of these on the map that we've gotten for 4.0, but Yoshi just being really, really quiet and hasn't said anything except for look forward to it and keep theory crafting.
Basically, the Japanese to English is Ho-Oh, but it's actually translated to Seiru. Probably butchered that as well. That's what it'll be here.
All right, cool. So the theory right now is that may be our new warring triad. Like, not actually called the warring triad, but our new warring triad.
Skying triad.
I was really looking forward to Hooters, honestly.
Yeah. There may be there may be an owl.
All beast I know triad. Is if it's Hooters, I just want to throw. I'll bring a Master Ball.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
I'm hoping there's going to be brothels, because I know there's a lot of brothels. I like brothels.
Wait, what?
I check an owner brothel. That'd be pretty cool.
What? Oh, brothel? I was making sure. At first I thought you said brothel, and I was like, it's a brothel? Oh, no. Your camera went drunk again, buddy. Oh, wait, came back. No, it's fine. Came back. It's okay.
Just needed some coffee. It's fine.
Yeah, no, I just zoomed back in. It was like, I'm not drunk. Just came right back. All right, PvP. Yeah. They're currently working on 4.0 PvP content, but it would require a lot more time to explain the revamp of all PvP aspects, likely not in 4.0, but later. More information before 4.0. I would say maybe, I would think 4.1 with all the PvP changes would probably take place, if I had to guess. Well, we have Season 4 of the Feast happening. That'll probably take until the launch, and then they'll do a then they'll have time to change it.
Will it be 4.1? Because that seems a bit late. I would expect like 4.5.
5B or 5A, you know.
Alright. Closer. Alright. Oh, yeah.
They are at least working on a PvP.
Yes. Yeah, because they want to try and make PvP a thing in this game. Well, like, I don't mind it. Like, I was really big with the feast when it, like, first came out, and I did try my best to get, you know, like, diamond tier. So, like, I think, like, this season, I got to, like, plat, and I was like, nah, I'm too busy with raiding, and I was playing other games. But also, like, they have to, like, change all this stuff now because of the new battle system changes. Well, it's going to be really annoying because then I'm just going to get, like, my ass beat by samurais and red mages constantly. I just see it happening.
Maybe not.
They might be really bad at PvPs.
Yeah.
No, well, they're not.
The idea of PvP just makes me want to do Tidus laugh, though, like, because, yeah, it's PvP.
I don't know. Klaus posted a link in chat, and it's Great King Mooglesput.
That is a beautiful thing.
It's kind of glorious.
But where's Flatus's face?
Oh no! Listen, my face has been photoshopped into pictures already from other podcasts. I'm not saying
that going on. We need to
if
keep
you
that going.
If you type somewhere Flatus Pugacorn, there
that's gonna be great.
Oh, there may be a picture of me out there with a certain former SOE community rep. So, you know, just old EverQuest Next stuff that
I'm so. Sorry, your search Flatus Pugacorn did not match any image results.
Oh, thank God. I think if you type Flatus in, though, that may pop up still. Let's find out.
I get a bunch of, yeah, no.
Yeah, no, that is some heavy metal shit! Look, when you search up Flatus, that is some hardcore, heavy metal shit right there.
You're welcome, by the way.
That is epic. For that.
So I searched up Flatus with two S's because that is also your thing.
It is,
and popping up on here, I have a selfie selfie from FanFest that includes you and Sunglare and Musecast, and I see Klaus in here.
Yep,
and I see a fat Pikachu.
Uh huh.
And Michael Scott and some of your former co-hosts.
Yeah. Fucking search my name. You get some weird shit apparently.
Yes, you do. Anyways,
you go deep.
Search up Flatus. The things I wish I could eat all the time: pizza,
ice cream. Please do, Klaus.
Thank God you just get a bunch of chilies if you search my name.
There's also a picture of Sarah when you search my name. Sarah, and a lot. There's also a lot of ladies. I'm not sure why.
You not turning to something?
What? Wink. Wink.
I start up Flatus and I just get a very sad potato.
Like, oh, that's...
What the fuck? I type Flatus and all I get is women.
That's unfortunate.
I'm not complaining.
It's good. I don't think we have it. Alright, well, do you guys have any final thoughts on any of the articles that, or any of the news coming out of these articles?
I feel the force of it's like I fucking took that out of the notes. You fuck.
So I'm gonna say no for Paul then. Chili.
They sure were notes and
we went through them.
Yeah, that is what happened. Also, so... Falcon for the win.
Yeah, Johnny Falcon.
Johnny Falcon.
Hashtag Bushlight. That's such a deep FC reference now. By the way, never type movie quotes in the FC chat when you're tired, because you'll mistype them.
Also, never give Flatus access to the Twitter account.
Yeah, because hashtag Mushlife will go out. So, shoutouts. Paul, Chili, you can fight over who goes first, but go ahead.
Chili goes first.
Shout out to, what's that place that I've been on recently? Shout out to Maelstrom Radio for having this on. Thank you so much. It's been fun. A shout out to Klaus at Phoenix Down Radio also. Shout out to Evolve Male, aka Samus Rageborn, aka your girlfriend's favorite streamer at twitch.tv/EvolveMale. Also.
Paul.
Oh shit, is it my turn? Sorry, my brain went black. I was still looking at the photos that I Googled Flatus for.
Never a good idea.
That's a deep rabbit hole.
The deep rabbit hole where Alice will never come out of. That sounded wrong in my head.
Search for my name on the deep web. See what you find.
I don't want to.
Go to a Tor browser.
You'd have to go to the deepest of webs for that.
Yeah, yeah. Go to a Tor browser, type in lava scorpion. See what you get.
Shout outs. Obviously, big shout out to Mushroom Radio.
Did you just say
they're awesome?
Mushroom Radio.
Yes. Mushroom Radio. No, the Maelstrom Radio, you know, they keep our seas safe so we can live on throughout Eorzea. But yeah, just big thank you. You guys are really sexy and just lovely guys. I don't want to click that link that someone's just put in chat. But yeah, just big thank you for letting us like come on. I haven't said that much like swear words. I'm going to say fuck, shit, cunt, bollocks, wanker. There we go, got it all out. Please don't cut that out. I want to hear that next time.
You didn't have to do the swearing.
I had to. I've been holding it in too much now. It had to come out.
I'm glad you you waited.
Yeah. A big shout also to my friend Azavar. He's going to CoupoCon this month in England. So big shout out to him, and he's a lovely guy. Shout out to Phoenix Down Radio because they help a lot with Moogle Around. Big shout out to those guys over there. That way. And a big shout out to Flatus because he still keeps my character in his FC. That is still level one and hasn't been leveled.
I'm just going to harass you consistently. Shin.
I got my shoutouts already in here, but shout out to Moogle Go Round. Can't speak today anymore. Thanks guys for coming on the show, and it's been awesome again. Also, shout out to Phoenix Down and Musecast, who are both awesome. And if you haven't, make sure you go and keep pestering the Square Enix support lines to make sure that they improve their systems.
Yes to improving, but... I forgot to put it in the shin. That's my fault. But she got her account back.
Yes.
I saw that on Twitter as well.
Sorry, pestering. The pesterings will continue until we get results.
Yeah. My shout outs are to, of course, Chili and Paul for one, giving us our first guest host and helping us get our name out there. It's a big thing when it comes to podcasts because you could just sit there in monotony and no one can find you. So you guys gave us our first hello out there, and that was really awesome. So thank you for that, and thanks to everyone that listens, of course, everyone that showed up tonight. I'd like to thank, as soon as it loads, all right, Cred13, Donkatron, Laughrican Prince.
Do you literally do this? Do you shout out everyone?
Yeah, I do. Lately. Because that you know what? That support. These guys sat here, first of all, sat through all this. More, almost 2 hours now, so I appreciate all of it. Laughrican Prince, of course, Notorious.
Oh my god.
Notorious BL3. Phoenix Down, Klaus, Priest Symphotica, and Yelta. I'm not... Listen, I already shouted out Chili and Paul. So you guys already got it. Thank you all. And also, Remixer, I'm so glad you got your account back. And, of course, you know, don't harass. Let's not harass people, but push.
I said pester. Calmly
remind that changing one's business practices and procedures is not necessarily a bad thing. We understand you need to protect your company, but guess what? You can do things a little better. Just saying. So thank you all for coming out and joining us for Maelstrom Radio. I'm gonna go ahead and mute the rest of these nerds. So I can start playing other music and get us out of here. And I guess I should probably do like show promotion and stuff when that's going on. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So thank you. You guys wanted to say goodbye one last time?
Which podcast I can try and pester to be on next.
Praise Lava Scorpion.
Praise Lava Scorpion.
Chili's Lava Scorpion. Chili's like old like 13th century England. He's slowly conquering podcasts with flags. He's like planting flags, and but he's like, this one's now mine. I claim you in the name of Chili.
I claim him in the name of Lava Scorpion.
Yes. You need tiny Lava Scorpion flags, and you can throw them at people at FanFest. Claim people in the name
can
of
we
Lava
get Scorpion. Can we get Lava Scorpion pins for next FanFest?
Sure.
I think we will have to do that.
Yeah, I think I've got to work on that now.
Yeah.
Be Lava Scorpion go round.
Yeah. That's your other podcast. It's
look,
the third it's
I can
the third sister
get Chili on for one. You know how busy Chili is? I can't get him on too. He's got so many out there. It's hard to go and get him on the Moogle.
It's just a 30-minute podcast about the love and praise of Lava Scorpion.
We'll just make it a seminar then.
Yeah.
Weekly religious teachings.
Yeah, of Lava Scorpion.
I kind of want to do that as a section of next Moogle go around now.
Yeah.
We're going to do that. That is a now thing.
Yeah, there you go. And now the bit where you guys talk about the religion of Lava Scorpion.
And now for the book of Lava Scorpion.
Yeah. Do you have a minute to talk about our Lord and Savior Lava Scorpion?
He died for your tombstones.
Yeah. I'm going to mute you guys now.
You do know we're going to do that.
I'm going to mute you. Muting you guys now. Bye, guys. All right. Got those shirts. So, thank you all for coming out to Maelstrom Radio. I appreciate it. It's so much fun having those guys on. Just to let you know, we're weekly here Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific. You can find us on iTunes, Google Play Music, and Stitcher. Go out, please give us a like and subscribe there and review our show. That really helps us get found not only on those sites, but you can share it with your friends or enemies or your family. We're a blog at maelstromradio.com. Our email address is show@maelstromradio.com. And you can find us on Twitter at maelstromradio, maelstrom_radio. Thank you all and see you all next week.
Maelstrom Radio is a production of maelstromradio.com, Blackfire Media Productions. Final Fantasy XIV and Eorzea are trademarks of Square Enix. Opening theme provided by Benjamin Anthony James. You can find more of their music over at soundcloud.com/Ben773. Our outro is provided by Sodo. You can find more of their music over at soundcloud.com/Sodo. Views and opinions expressed on this episode are those of Maelstrom Radio and their hosts, and do not reflect the views and opinions of Square Enix. And until C swallows all, keep listening.
Lava Scorpion will rise.